Thanks, John. Coming to San Jose is always a scary experience for me because when I leave from Phoenix, Arizona, the flight to San Jose, Costa Rica, often boards at the same time in the adjacent gate. So I've never made that mistake more than once. So I've been involved in basically in ARIN as a legacy holder since day one. And over the last 20 years as a member for different organizations. And my friends suggested that I stand for the AC, as I've got a lot of experience in the traditional operator space, but also in the wireless and the internet exchange provider space. Right now, my volunteer job is as the CEO for NinjaIX, where we operate 5 internet exchanges today throughout in the United States, and we have another 2 coming on online in the next quarter. And so I deal with everybody from a small startup that has a /24 all the way up to the big boys that are in the CDN space. And so I'm always being asked for a lot of unsolicited advice and how to operate, how to get addresses, how to operate, and a lot of technical questions as well, mostly pertaining to BGP. But I have a lot of people that are always asking ARIN questions, and I try to direct them into the right place. My paying job right now is primarily assisting a couple wireless equipment vendors with their customers getting their networks transitioned. And by transitioned, I mean from using RFC 1918 space a lot of times and NAT and using RIP to using IPv6 and the IPv4, IPv6 transition space. So the a lot of times that's a very frightening experience whenever they realize that they are going to be dealing with ARIN. On the legacy side, we kind of have the same thing as well. We still work with a couple organizations that have legacy space, and the only 3 letters they fear most, well, that's not true, probably the 3 letters they fear slightly less than ARIN is the IRS. So I think as an organization, we can do a lot more for outreach and education and comfort them as to helping maintain who is contacts and also doing assignments and reallocations as well. So over the years, I've attended a lot of the ARIN meetings whenever I can. I've, since the ARIN on the Roads have come online, I've gone to many of those as well. I've brought along or encouraged our customers to attend those as well. So where I'm at in my career, I now have a lot of time and obviously effort that I can put forth to serve on the advisory council and assist with the other communities in the ARIN area. So that's pretty much why I'm standing here for election. Would appreciate your support. If you have any questions, I'll be around. Feel free to reach out. Thanks.
Thank you.